Yeah! Come on!
Well, it is a pitch-perfect afternoon at Yankee Stadium in the Bronx for the third game of this four-game set between two American League East Division rivals. Today, it's the Tampa Bay Rays taking on the New York Yankees from Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Yankee Stadium. I'm Matthew Kaufman. This is a third game of this four-game series between these two teams. Yankees in the last 10 games are 7-3, where the Rays are 6-4. Yankees' batting average at .259, but it really extended a little bit yesterday with Anthony Rizzo and the help that he gave the Yankees. Two home runs in the game, one of them coming in the first inning off of Kelly. That was into the low right field seats. But then the other big swing in the eighth inning, and that one was the difference maker, and that was the game winner for Anthony Rizzo in the right center field for the two-run home run and a little curtain call for the Yankee first baseman. So, season at home here in 23 games, he's batting first in the American League rankings at .361 with a .361 average. He's tied for second in the American League with seven home runs, a .443 on base percentage, and he's slugging at .651. And that's how hot that he has been. Well, we got the pitching matchup next. Shane McClanahan and Nestor Cortez Jr. Mariner Marakovic has more when we come back.
Pitching matchup features a pair of southpaws. The Tampa Bay Rays will send Shane McClanahan to the mound. He's been absolutely outstanding to start the year. 7-0, a sub-2 ERA, and he has struck out 58 batters along the way. The Yankees are going to counter with Nestor Cortez, who's been pretty solid in his own right. With the exception of that hiccup against the Texas Rangers, Cortez has allowed 3 earned runs or fewer in 6 out of the 7 games he has started. There is no question, though, this Yankees offense is going to have their work cut out for him. I asked Aaron Boone what the key is against a guy like McClanahan.
Lefty power arm up to 100. Breaking ball, really good changeup. One of the game's best. So, you got your work cut out for you. Got to take advantage of the few mistakes that you hopefully get. But you know, you got a challenge with when he's going.
And while Aaron Boone would always like length out of his starter, they should be in pretty good shape as far as the bullpen is concerned. It looks like they'll have everyone available with the exception of Michael King, who threw 27 pitches last night. Plenty more to come here on the YES Network. When we get back, Michael K will be joined by Paul O'Neill. First pitch coming your way after the break.
Well, welcome back to Yankees Baseball on YES. Today's game presented by FanDuel. Take your bet and a chance to win. Also by LNYU Langone Health. Hashtag the best outcomes. And by New York Lottery. Get out there and play. Well, that's what these two teams are going to look to do today. Rays and the Yankees. Third game of this four-game series between the Rays and the Yankees. Two AL East teams that are looking to really bounce back after the Rays lost last night to the Yankees. Let's take a look at today's starting lineups between the Rays and the Yankees. Leading off at first base, it'll be Yandy Diaz, and batting second, Wander Franco at short. Batting third, Harold Ramirez, the DH. Batting fourth, Rene Rosarena in left. Isaiah Paredes, the third baseman, bats fifth. Batting sixth, the second baseman, Taylor Walls. Batting seventh, right fielder, Manuel Margot. Batting eighth, the center fielder, Jose Siri. And batting ninth, the catcher, Francisco Mejia. Well, now let's take a look at the Yankees starter today. That'll be Nestor Cortes Jr., 7 games, 3.2 ERA. Would like to get that start against the Rangers out of his head. And he's got to get back on track. As we look at the pitching scouting report presented by Nissan, hitting 176. That's what batting averages against Cortes has been. And as a Yankee, he has pitched well against the Tampa Bay Rays. Well, we get ready for first pitch here at Yankee Stadium. Let's take a look at the umpires for today. Home plate umpire, Sean Barber. First base umpire, Mike Mushklinski. Second base umpire, Alan Porter. And third base umpire, Nate Tomlinson. Well, you see the customized cleats for Nestor Cortes Jr. today, as Nestor Cortes is going to try and battle against this Rays lineup and do some damage. As you see the horses from Cortes. So Nestor Cortes Jr. is ready. Diaz ready. Here we go from the Bronx at a gorgeous Saturday afternoon. First pitch is under the glove of LeMahieu and into left field for a base hit. So a leadoff single. Let's take a look at the Yankees defense behind Cortes. In left field, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Harrison Bader in center. Jake Bowers in right. LeMahieu, Volpe, Torres, Rizzo, third to first. Kyle Higashioka behind the plate. Nestor Cortes Jr. on the mound. And, of course, Aaron Judge will be the DH, as it just got under the glove of DJ LeMahieu to start it off. Here is Harold Ramirez. He swings at the first pitch. This one fielded by LeMahieu to second. On to first, it's a double play to get Franco. 5-4-3 go the Rays. And just like that, two pitches and two quick outs. Let's take a look at the Yankees' keys to the game. The best win of the year so far. Last night, Anthony Rizzo with two big home runs in the game. A first-inning shot, as we mentioned earlier, in the eighth-inning home run. Anthony Volpe with a home run in that game as well. And then a big single in the seventh, along with the single by Oswaldo Cabrera to extend the lead at that point. Then that three-run home run. Here's the 1-0-2 Ramirez. He swings and misses there. Oh, make the count 1-1. Ramirez, 320 batting average. He's been a very good hitter for the Tampa Bay Rays this year to start off. Here's the 1-1 in there for strike, and it's 1-2 on Ramirez. Here's the 1-2 pitch. It's on the ground to Anthony Volpe, who fields and fires across, and he's got Ramirez. So a quick inning for Cortes. No runs, a hit. Nobody left on base. Yankees coming to bat. Well, welcome back to Yankee Stadium. Bottom of the first inning on this gorgeous Saturday afternoon. Let's take a look at the Yankees starting lineup presented by TikTok. Leading off at second base, Gleyber Torres. Batting second, the DH, Aaron Judge. Batting third, first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. Batting fourth, third baseman, DJ LeMahieu. Batting fifth, center fielder Harrison Bader. Batting sixth, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa in left. Batting seventh, the shortstop Anthony Volpe. Batting eighth, the right fielder Jake Bowers. And batting ninth, Kyle Higashioka. And they're going to face the guy that has had such a great start to the year, Shane McClanahan. 8 starts this year, 7-0 with a 1.76 ERA. And let's take a look at the pitching scouting report. It is ridiculous. He has been so great for the Tampa Bay Rays. A 4 spot. And he has had great success against the New York Yankees. Well, Shane McClanahan is going to face Gleyber Torres to start things off. The first pitch to Torres is a swing and a miss, 0-1. Torres has reached base safely in his last 8 games, dating back to May 5th. Torres batting .252 with 6 home runs on the year. The 0-1 in the air to right center field. Deep. Margot there at the warning track. He makes the catch. And the first out for McClanahan. Let's take a look at the defense behind him. Randy Rosarena in left. Jose Siri in center. Manuel Margot in right. Paredes, Franco, Walls, and Diaz third to first. Francisco Mejia behind the plate. Shane McClanahan, of course, on the mound. And then the DH, Harold Ramirez. Here's Aaron Judge. That's upstairs, 1-0. He was 0-for-3 yesterday with a walk. That walk set up the Anthony Rizzo two-run home run. There's the 1-0. And the dirt, 2-0. Did he go around? No, he did not. So it stays 2-0. Well, Garrett Cole, who did not get a decision yesterday, who allowed two or few runs fewer in his 8 of 9 starts so far that season. Yankees are 8-1 in starts that he's pitched, but Nestor Cortez, who has gone 9-2 with a 2.45 ERA as a Yankee at Yankee Stadium, and the count 3-1 on Judge. So definitely a good pitching matchup today between McClanahan and Cortez. Here's the 3-1 to Judge. A slider in there for a strike, and the count full 3-2 to Aaron Judge. You saw the custom cleats. Patty, that's his mom, who was all over the place last year when Judge was trying to reach the record mark of those home runs. Judge in the air to right field down the line, foul, and he stays alive. And the count's still 3-2. Let's take a look at the game time weather presented by Bigelow Tea. 77 degrees, feels like 87, wind blowing out to left field. 25% chance of rain, and the humidity is high. 3-2. That's high into the seats, foul, and it stays 3-2 again. Went back to the curveball to Judge. All right, Aaron Judge coming off the injured list a few weeks ago. Was out with that injury on the IL, and he works a walk to get the first base runner of the game for the Yankees. Well, Judge has reached in 24 of his 30 games this year. He's hit safely in 17 of those games. And that brings up Rizzo, who's got the average over to just 300, batting 301 with 8 home runs. But Anthony Rizzo was the hero last night, without a doubt. And the Yankees would love to keep him going against the lefty Shane McClanahan. First pitch to Rizzo is fouled off, and that got a piece of Mejia, the catcher. And Rizzo wincing over there, as he knows. Well, he is the Mandalorian. That's without a doubt, and we know that because, well, he had bobblehead night here last night at Yankee Stadium. And, well, he was the guy of the night for the New York Yankees. And Mejia being attended to by the athletic trainer of the Tampa Bay Rays, and you see Kevin Cash, the manager of the Rays out there as well, as it got a piece of them. But Anthony Rizzo, it was really been a big part. Let's take a look back at last night. This was in the first inning off of Kelly, down into the right field seats, about two rows up, but then the big, big swing in the eighth inning. That was the game winner for the Yankees, and a little curtain call at the end of it for Rizzo, after having a huge night against this division opponent. So, big swings from Rizzo and chance to continue to do so here in this early setting of the first inning. One on, one out, 0-1 pitch to Rizzo. Missed low, and it's 1-1. Shane McClanahan could really dial up the fastball, get it up to about 97, 98 miles an hour. One of the best left-handers in the league. 1-1. Grounded foul, 1-2 to Rizzo. Yankees, Aaron Boone, manager, changed the lineup up a little bit. He mentioned the other day, putting Volpe lower in the lineup. Torres leading off right now. DJ LeMahieu bats fourth. He's on deck for the Yankees. Time called by Rizzo. 1-2 still. Well, Shane McClanahan, 58 strikeouts this year. Now 21 walks on the year with that walk to Judge. But that ERA of a 1.76, the best. Rizzo on the ground to second. Tough play, Franco. Flip of the bag to second, and they get Judge with Walls covering. Nice play by Wander Franco to get over there as they get Aaron Judge, and he is going to head back to the Yankee dugout. And they are going to maybe take a look at this. Let's take a look at this ourselves as Franco just got it. Let's see if he's on the bag. He indeed is. Another look at it. He caught it in the bare hand. But the question is, did he have it? He did, and that is out number two. So here's LeMahieu, Rizzo with the fielder's choice. LeMahieu batting 270 for the Yankees. He's also been a big part of this Yankee lineup in recent weeks. The way that he's been able to swing the bat. He's reached space in 27 of the 33 games as a starter this year, hitting 357 with runners in scoring position. Three doubles, 11 RBIs, five walks. He's been the RBI machine as usual for the Bronx Bombers. LeMahieu caught by Franco at short, and that'll do it. No runs, no hits, nobody scores for the Yankees. We go to the second. Welcome back to Yankee Stadium, top half of the second inning from the Bronx. No score in the first as it's an overcast day here at Yankee Stadium. Kenester Cortez Jr. out for his second inning of work. He'll face Randy Arozarena. Cortez gave up one hit but then got the double play from Franco. And then the ground out to Ramirez. That was the top of the first. As Arozarena squared to bunt, pulled it back, takes a strike. Well, you look at the cleats of Cortez. That was from the Kentucky Derby. As that cutter just missed a little high, 1-0. Excuse me, 1-1. But he picked the horse, and the horse number 65 for Nestor Cortez. A new theme every week, or every start, you could say. That pitch missed outside, and it's 2-1 on Cortez. Tam Major, assuming that's the name of the horse that Cortez had. That's grounded and gloved by LeMahieu. Long throw to first, not in time. Arozarena beats it out. Great play by LeMahieu. Just did not have enough arm strength to get the fast Arozarena. So here's Isaac Paredes. 35 games this year, four home runs, 273 batting average, and he has been a very big addition for the Tampa Bay Rays this year. So one on, no one out. Here is Paredes, takes a strike, 0-1. Arozarena threat to run at second base. Taylor Wall, who's on deck for Tampa Bay. 0-1 count on Paredes. Fouled it straight back, 0-2. Lester Cortez, who has bounced around and struggling in recent starts for the Yankees, had that really ugly start in Texas against the Rangers a few weekends ago. So it has been not an easy start to the year for Cortez. Remember, he pitched so great last year like an all-star. The 0-2, up and away, 1-2 on Cortez. Or excuse me, from Cortez to Paredes. Once you come in from Nestor Cortez. The 1-2. Lined into right center field. There's a base hit. Bowers will field it and get it in quickly. Arozarena will stop at second as Bowers fires it in a third. And the Rays with a little something brewing here in the second. With first and second, nobody out. As Paredes got it in on the hands. Didn't get all the barrel of that one, but shoots it the other way. And Cortez in a little bit of a pickle here, first and second, nobody out. Taylor Walls coming to the plate for the Rays. When you look at for the Yankees facing a guy like McClanahan, who's a really good pitcher. You don't want to fall too far behind in the score. This would be huge if Cortez can get out of trouble here. Taylor Wall's the batter. 261, 6 home runs on the year. 13 RBIs and a chance to add on to it with a runner in scoring position here for Tampa Bay in the early second inning. Here's the 1-0. Fouled straight back, 1-1. Taylor Walls, who's been a big guy for this Tampa Bay Rays team, offensively and defensively as well. You can see Rizzo is all the way up on the grass at first base. Here's the 1-1 to Walls, and Cortez will step off. Still 1-1. Walls can bunt, and you saw Anthony Rizzo was expecting it. He did not indeed go around like he was going to bunt. 1-1. Lined in the left field. There's a base hit. Coming around to score is a Rosarena. Here's the throw home. It's not in time. It's an RBI single for Walls. And it's 1-0 Tampa Bay. Here's another look at a high cutter from Cortez. And Taylor Walls picks up an RBI here in the second. Great jump by Rosarena. Helmet comes flying off. He kicked it a little bit. And he comes around to score. So here's Manuel Margot here in the top half of the second inning. Margot in 32 games, not off to the best start. Does have a couple of home runs, batting 250. The 1-0 is way outside. 2-0. Well, Mr. Cortez would like to have a better start than he did last time, and that, of course, being the fact that he struggled in Texas. He struggled so a few times this year. That's just missed upstairs, 3-0. But Rosarena, who kicked the helmet up in the air, and luckily enough for him that it did not trip him. Because maybe that play turns the other way for the Yankees if it does. 3-0, that's a strike. 3-1. Jose Siri waiting on deck for Tampa Bay. Seven hitter at the plate in Margot. Eight hitter on deck in Siri. The 3-1 pitch. Still nobody out here in the second in a 1-0 game. That's fouled away, and it's 3-2. Another look at it. Fouled it straight back. Just a little late on it. Payoff pitch to Manuel Margot is on the ground to third. LeMahieu on the second one. On the first big double play. Paredes will move to third. But Manuel Margot grounds into a 5-4-3 double play. And that's big for the Yankees, for Cortez especially. And here's the center fielder, Jose Siri, who was with the Houston Astros last year and came over to the Yankees, or excuse me, to the Rays near the trade deadline. 0-1 on Jose Siri. Tampa Bay Rays lead 1-0 here in the second on the RBI by Walls. That's it on the hands, 1-1 on Jose Siri. Paredes is at third with two outs. One pitch is a swing and a miss there. 94 dialed it up that time from Cortez. 1-2. Give credit if Cortez could get out of this with only allowing one run after having first and second, nobody out, a run scored, then first and second, still nobody out. Now holding a one-run lead of the Rays. But they do got the ace of the staff on the mound in Shane McClanahan. One-two pitch coming to Jose Siri. Cortez taking his time. The 1-2. Swing and a miss got him. Siri strikes out, and that'll do it in the second. One run and a couple of hits for the Rays. Welcome back to Yankees Baseball. Let's take a look at the Montefiore Einstein injury report, starting with Giancarlo Stanton. Participated in baseball activities last 2 days here at Yankee Stadium. Does not have a timetable for return, but hopefully to play in outfield this season. He's been on the IL since April 16th with a left hamstring injury. And here is Giancarlo Stanton taking some drills in the outfield. Was running a little better with that left hamstring. As Harrison Bader leads things off in the bottom of the second inning, upstairs 1-0 to Bader. Bader 382. He's been the one of the most consistent batters for the Yankees, besides it seems like Anthony Rizzo, and that's a strike 1-1 to Bader. Bader had that big game against the Rays where he got that game-winning hit, it seemed like, and then the Rays walked it off on that Sunday afternoon last weekend. 2-1 count on Harrison Bader. The 2-1 is low and away. 3-1 on Bader. Rays lead 1-0 on the RBI single by Taylor Walls in the top half of the second. 3-1 pitch from McClanahan is a strike, and the count's full 3-2 with Connor Falefa on deck. 3-2 pitch coming to Harrison Bader. That's fouled straight back, still 3-2. Harrison Bader, since coming back from the injury list, has been amazing for the New York Yankees. They have loved having him back in 10 games this year, batting 382, two triples, three homers. He's reached base in 9 of his 10 games. 3-2 pitch. Lined into center field. Siri going back, and he'll make the catch. Out number one here in the second. Well, take a look at StatCast 3D. Let's take a look at the pitching arsenal for Shane McClanahan. And that fastball, changeup, curveball, and slider. You see the average spin rate percentage, and you see the average miles an hour on it. Here's IKF. There's the strike, 0-1. Connor Falefa has reached base in 10 of his 15 starts this year. Was 0 for 2 on Friday, though, last night. It's a little ground ball to Wander Franco, who fields over to first to Diaz, two down. And that'll bring up the rookie Anthony Volpe. Let's take a look at the ERA leaders in the American League since 2021. Ohtani, of course, at the top. Shane McClanahan second. Alek Manoah, Framber Valdez, and then another Yankee starter. The counterpart today for McClanahan, Nestor Cortez. So here's Volpe. Takes a strike, 0-1. Volpe has 5 home runs this year as a rookie with the Yankees. Had one of them last night. The 0-1. Swing and a miss. Bat goes flying out of the hands of Volpe. Did not have enough grip on that bat as it went flying out of his hands. There's another look. Chase the slider way out of the zone, and it just usually the ball goes that way. This time the bat does for Anthony Volpe, 0-2. As he will get a new bat, hopefully a little bit better grip on this one for Volpe. Well, Volpe, since coming to the Yankees as a major leaguer, has been great. He has struggled offensively at some times. He has reached base safely in 9 of his 12 starts and in 23 of his last 28 starts. But his 11 stolen bases are tied for 10th most in the majors, 6th in the AL. That's a swing and a miss, and Volpe strikes out, throws the bat like it left his hands in a 1-2-3 inning for McClanahan. We're through. Welcome back to Yankee Stadium here in the Bronx. Let's take a look at today's Toyota Pinstripe Pride, Matthew and Joey. And if you want to be featured in a upcoming game, go to hashtag Toyota Pinstripe Pride and post your picture on Twitter, Instagram, any type of social media, and you may be lucky to have yours in a future game. So here's Francisco Mejia, the catcher. He pops it up foul, 0-1. 9-1-2 in the order for the Rays here in the top of the third. 18 games started this year for Mejia. He splits the time usually with Bethencourt, the other Rays catcher. The 0-1 popped up. Second base for Gleyber Torres as he calls off Volpe to make the catch. And there's one away. And now the top of the order for the Rays and Yandy Diaz, who singled on the first pitch of the ballgame to left field. Diaz has had a great start to the year. 316, 9 home runs for Yandy Diaz. First pitch is grounded off his foot. Foul on one. Nestor Cortez Jr. love a quick inning here. Already at the 30-pitch mark for the Rays. Team that is going to make Yankee pitchers really throw some pitches. The 0-1. Miss Lotes, 1-1. One one to Diaz is fouled away. And it's 1-2 on Diaz. Well, coming up after this series against the Rays tomorrow, they'll continue their 17 games in a row with facing the road trip of the Blue Jays, and then they head over to Cincinnati for a 3-game series against the Reds. And as of right now, it'll be for tomorrow. Clark Schmidt gets the mound in the final game of this series between the Rays. 3-2 pitch coming to Yandy Diaz once again. On the ground is short. Anthony Volpe there. He fires to first. He gets Diaz to get out number two. And then after for the Rays, is Wander Franco comes to the plate, grounded into a double play in the first inning on the second pitch of the game from Cortez. But after the Yankees take on the Rays, they got the Blue Jays, as we said, and then the Reds. But then they come home to play the Orioles. And then, of course, after that, they got the Padres coming to town. Here's the 0-1 to Franco. There's a strike going too quickly on Wander Franco. Oh, 2. Strike 3 looking. Franco down on strikes, and that'll do it. Well, don't forget your Yankees short sleeve hoodie night here against the Padres on May 26th. First pitch at 7:05. First 18,000 guests, 21 and older, will get a Yankees short sleeve hoodie. Well, bottom of the third inning, it'll start with the 8-hitter, Jake Bowers. Time called by home plate umpire. Well, Bowers in 8 games this year for the Yankees, batting .278 with 2 home runs. So first pitch to Bowers, miss low, 1-0. So 1-0 on Jake Bowers. McClanahan in his third inning of work now against the Yanks. Bowers in the air to center field. Long run for Siri. It's going to dunk in there for base in as Siri grabs it with his bare hand, but a leadoff single for Jake Bowers. And look at that sweet swing of Bowers, lefty-on-lefty matchup. Aaron Boone put him in against left-handers because he could do the damage. Here's the nine-hitter, Kyle Higashioka, the Yankee catcher today. Trevino with the day off, a swing and a miss there by Higashioka. 0-1. Jake Bowers for the Yankees came in, kind of did what Matt Carpenter did a little bit. Homered in Tampa Bay. Franchy Cordero was compared a little bit to Matt Carpenter, but then he got sent down to the minor leagues. Jake Bowers, who is scorching down in AAA, gets called up. Higashioka takes a strike 1-2. Well, Bowers has reached base multiple times in three of his five starts. 4-for-14 with two runs, two homers. Entered Friday's game as a pinch hitter for Connor Falefa. Had four hits on Thursday versus Tampa Bay. Went 2-for-4. Was the only Yankee to record a hit over those first 8 innings of the game. Higashioka fouled it away. Bowers was running on the pinch, 2-2. To Higashioka. Bowers does have some good speed as well. Power and speed combination. You see, shift is somewhat on for Higashioka. They do still have to have those two infielders to the right side of second base and the left side. That's up and in. It's 3-2 on Kyle Higashioka. Top of the order coming up for the Yankees. And Gleyber Torres. 3-2 pitch coming. Outside and away, he walked him. It's 4. And that is going to bring up Gleyber Torres with Yankees having first and second, nobody out. And the Yankee leadoff hitter to the plate. Batting 256 home runs for New York. Torres would love to drive in a run here. Tie this game up or do more than that. First pitch. Curveball upstairs, 1-0. Bowers at second. Higashioka is at first after the walk. And the 1-0 count to Gleyber Torres. Pitch from McClanahan. Driven in the air to center field. Jose Siri underneath it. He makes the catch. Bowers bluffs the tag. And there is one down here in the third for Aaron Judge. Man, would Judge love to get himself back going again? Not just he would love to, but so would the Yankees. 62 home runs last year. It was healthy for a lot of it. One out, two on for the Yanks. First pitch. Driven in the air to center field. Deep to right center-ish. Siri makes the catch. Bowers completely tags this time. And Judge flies out. But moving the third is Bowers. And now the Yankees have first and third, two outs. Here's that man, Anthony Rizzo. Two home runs last night. Could he get some runs in here? With a chance to tie the game with a base hit. Of course, he could do more damage with one swing, though. Runners on the corners, two outs. Yankees threatening against the ace, McClanahan. Pitch low, 1-0. Let's take a look at StatCast's 3D presented by Google Cloud. He's got 44 hits this year, 12 of them the opposite field, six of them up the middle. 26 to the pull side. And that is 44 total hits for Rizzo. This year has been really, really good for the New York Yankees. 2-0 pitch to Rizzo, time called by the Rizzo. LeMahieu is on deck for the Yanks. Their RBI machine. 2-0 count on Rizzo. That's in on the corner. Strike one, 2-1 for Rizzo. Well, Rizzo, who, when he hit those two home runs last night, he had a runner on base in the eighth inning, did not have anybody on in the first on the solo shot. That's low, and it's 3-1 on Anthony Rizzo. DJ LeMahieu on deck. Three and one pitch. McClanahan is set. The 3-1 is fouled off. 3-2 to Rizzo. Good battle here for Rizzo. McClanahan up on the pitch count. 48 pitches. About to throw pitch number 49 here to Anthony Rizzo. Here in this game. And you can see him choking up on the top of the grip strength. Top of the bat grip. 0-2, 3-2, fouled away again. Rizzo still battling with two outs. This game presented by Google Capital One. What's in your wallet? Rizzo hopes to get an RBI pulled out of his somehow. 3-2. And Rizzo will once again call time. Trying to gather himself before this next 3-2 pitch to Rizzo. 3-2 the count. Another one grounded foul. Still 3-2 on Rizzo. Three, two pitch. Runners on the corners. Higashioka will run at second in the air to center field. Long run for Siri. He comes in to make the catch, and that'll do it. All three outs in the inning go to Siri, and the Yankees don't score in the third. Oh, welcome back to Yankees Baseball. And yes, don't forget to shop Yankees at MLBShop.com. A Fanatics experience there at Central Bryant Park Lawn. Nestor Cortes out there for his fourth inning of work here for the Yankees. We look at the Cadillac scoreboard. 1-4-0 for the Yankee, or for the Rays, 0-1-0 for New York. So here's Harold Ramirez. He will lead things off in the fourth against Cortes on the ground, and a diving play by LeMahieu sets and fires to first in time. Oh, what a play by LeMahieu to get out number one. He's a gold glover, ladies and gentlemen, for a reason. And a spectacular diving stop by the Yankee third baseman. Man, is he special over there at third. Here is Arozarena, swings at the first pitch and flies it in a set left. Long run for Tyner Falefa, and he makes the catch. Two quick outs. And another look here at the DJ LeMahieu diving play at third. He is just something else over there at third base for the New York Yankees. And Nestor Cortes loving it, pointing over there. So here's Isaac Paredes. Takes a fastball up and away, 1-0 for Paredes. The 1-0, 2-0 on Paredes. Isaac Paredes, who for the Rays. Playing third base. There's a strike, 2-0 Now 2-1. Well, Nestor Cortez, remember, mentioned earlier, 39 Ks coming into the game, 11 walks, and a high ERA of over 4, 7.7. That's down the left field line. Long run for Falefa. Not going to get there. It's into the seats and foul. As the fan fake to throw it back. He did not. He's going to keep that souvenir. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs, top of the fourth inning. Cortez looking for a quick inning of work here in the fourth against the Rays. And that fan gave that youngster the ball. As that's fouled away, it's still 3-2. Another look at that. Kid comes to the ballpark. He's going to get a good smile here today. 3-2 once again, fouled away again, and it's still 3-2 on Paredes. Well, coming up for the Yankees, it'll be LeMahieu, Bader, and Connor Falefa in the fourth. 3-2 pitch in the air to center field. Harrison Bader underneath it. Sizes it up, and he makes the catch, and that'll do it. A 1-2-3 fourth inning. Yankee fans making youngsters smile here in the fourth. Welcome back to Yankee Stadium. Let's take a look at the Yes Trivia question. Who are the only two players to hit 20-plus home runs and 20-plus stolen bases in a season at the age of 38 or older? LeMahieu takes the first pitch inside 1-0 as the Cadillac scoreboard 1-0 Tampa Bay. LeMahieu lined out the first in his first at-bat of the game. It'll be LeMahieu, Bader, and Connor Falefa here in the fourth. 2-0 on LeMahieu. Takes a strike, 2-1. Well, LeMahieu made that really nice diving play at third. Last inning, or excuse me, the top half of the fourth. So last half inning, 2-1. Grounded to right field. There's a base hit for LeMahieu. A base hit for DJ. And another look at it as he goes the other way, as per usual, for DJ LeMahieu. And he is just, he's something else for the New York Yankees. He's great defensively. He's even better offensively, it seems like. So here is Harrison Bader with one on, nobody out here in the fourth. Yankees trail to the Rays 1-0 on the runs in the second inning from the Rays off the bat of Taylor Walls. Rosarena came around to score in that inning. Cortez did do a great job of getting out of it, though, with only one run being allowed. 1-0 count on Harrison Bader. Pitch count at 56. Pitch 57 from McClanahan. A curveball in there for a strike. 1-1. Harrison Bader, we mentioned, had a big, big game against the Rays. Had a big weekend, really, against the Rays. Last weekend in Tampa at Tropicana Field. Some big hits, some big home run in that series. 1-2 to Connor Falefa. Bader at the plate. Swing and a miss. Got Bader, and that'll bring up Connor Falefa here for the Rays. And McClanahan, who really has been the ace for the Rays. But another thing to look at for Connor Falefa, who's at the plate, it's a lefty on righty matchup, and Connor Falefa, who's got a good ability to go the other way. But in the first two seasons here with the Yankees, Connor Falefa's kind of struggled offensively. Struggled defensively last year, but he's moved a little bit around. This popped up. Long run for Franco. Makes the catch. Oh, nice grab there by Franco. And LeMahieu will stay at first. Had a long way to go. Did Wander Franco to make that play. And just had to reach over that right shoulder to grab it. Really nice play by Franco. And that's exactly how it's done defensively. He is a spectacular young rising shortstop in this Tampa Bay Rays organization. Arozarena wasn't going to get there. Franco called him off. So now Anthony Volpe takes a curveball for a strike, 0-1. He struck out in the second inning. Had a couple of big hits yesterday, including a home run earlier in the game, and then a big RBI single in the fourth inning. Excuse me, in the seventh inning. Homered in that fourth. And now here in the bottom of the fourth and a 1-1 count. LeMahieu staying at first right now. 1-1 pitch to Anthony Volpe. Is fouled away. 1-2 on Volpe. 1-2 coming to Volpe. McClanahan deals the 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, got him. Volpe strikes out for the second time, and that will end the inning here in the fourth. 1-0 Rays through four in the Bronx. McClanahan throwing some gas. Well, welcome back to Yankee Stadium. Here's a look at Wander Franco, and you see Shane McClanahan going over to him saying, thank you for making that grab. And probably saving an extra base hit with Connor Falefa, who was running. So here's Taylor Walls. He'll lead off the fifth inning. And an RBI single, the difference maker so far in this game. The only Rays run of the day. 0-2 on Taylor Walls coming from Nestor Cortez. 0-2 pitch. Awaiting. Cortez deals. Swing and a miss. Got him with the fastball upstairs. Here's another look. This takes us back a few days of Wander Franco. He could really make some spectacular grabs. He grabbed that with a bare hand. Did Wander Franco. He is something else for the Tampa Bay Rays. And he's going to continue to be something else big time for Tampa Bay. 2.5 WAR this season. That's second best, tied with Ohtani. 1-1 on Manuel Margot. Grounded into a double play in the second inning. That really helped out Cortez. Top of the fifth, 1-1. Miss low, 2-1 on Margot. Well, the Yankees have had five of the Yankees' last seven wins have been come-from-behind wins. And they're going to have to come from behind here, down 1-0 in the fifth. 3-1 count on Margot. Yankees trail by one. 3-1 pitch from Manuel Margot is popped up. But foul, and it's 3-2 on Margot. Great pitch count opportunity for Cortez. Just 55 pitches right now. McClanahan's over 60. Beautiful day. Warm. Sun's not too shining, and that's ball four. Margot works a walk. One on, one out for Jose Siri. That pitch just missed a little low and away. And Cortez didn't really like that one, as it did just miss the bottom of the zone there. So one on, one out for Siri here in the fifth. Rays lead 1-0 over the Yankees. In the air to right field, long run for Bowers, and it's going to go to the seats foul. 0-1. Siri struck out in the second inning against Cortez. That ended the inning. Well, let's take a look back. And, well, this was the bare hand by Mitchell. The 0-1 is low, 1-1, as it was dropped. Another look. Yeah. Something special, and even the catcher says, wow. Some plays you don't see every day. That's for sure. 1-1 pitch coming to Jose Siri. Check on the runner Margot at first. As Cortez uses his 1 of 2 pickoff attempts. One and two count on Jose Siri. Excuse me, 1-1 count on Siri. Upstairs, 2-1 on Siri. Cortez has only allowed one run in this game, but the base runners have been a little bit of an issue. And three base runners in the second inning. That's really been it, plus the walk here, and it's fallen behind 3-1 as Cortez on Siri. 3-1 count coming from Cortez to the 8-hitter Jose Siri on deck. Francisco Mejia, the catcher, awaiting. 3-1 is a swing and a miss. Excuse me, that's fouled off, actually, of Siri. 3-2. 3-2 coming to Siri. Well, Gerrit Cole, who loves pitching here in New York, he's allowed three or fewer runs in each of his 26 starts at Yankee Stadium since July 4th of 2021. That's the longest such streak by a Yankee starter in franchise history. He definitely loves putting his pinstripes on and pitching in the Bronx. 3-2 pitch to Siri is fouled away. 3-2. Margot was running on the pitch. And Siri staying alive here. Still 3-2. This is a big inning for Cortez if he can get out of this. Pitch through five innings of work. 3-2 coming from Cortez. Time called. And a pitch clock violation. Wow. So Cortez is going to, without throwing a pitch, he walks Siri. And a pitch clock violation on Cortez. Wow. And Matt Blake, the pitching coach, is going to come out and talk to Cortez. Now, if you're wondering how to score that, I'll tell you how I do. I put PCV, pitch clock violation. That's how I would assume if you're going to score it in your scorebooks today. You know, if you're at Yankee Stadium trying to figure out how, and you see this later on, you'll know how. So that brings up Francisco Mejia with first and second, one out in the fifth. 1-0 Rays lead and chance to do some more damage here against Cortez. Top of the fifth inning in the Bronx. Gorgeous game for baseball. It's warm, sun shining, but not too bright. On this 70-plus degree day in the Bronx on a Saturday afternoon. So here's Mejia. Ground to foul, 0-1. It'll be Mejia and then Yandy Diaz awaiting on deck. For the Rays, you're in the bottom of the top of the fifth inning. If you look ahead to the bottom of the fifth inning, it'll be Bowers, Higashioka, and Torres will bat in the bottom half against McClanahan. The 0-1. Cortez missed low, 1-1. One and one count on Mejia. Nine hitter in the Rays lineup here in the top of the fifth inning. Chance to do some more damage. Cortez with a check at second. Not in time to get Margot as he just beat it back. Another look. As Torres had to pick that one right out of the dirt. 1-1 count on Nestor Cortez to Mejia. That's low, 2-1 on Mejia. Two-one pitch coming to Francisco Mejia. Rays already at first and second, one out of the fifth. And 2-1. Inside, it's 3-1. And Yandy Diaz on deck for the Rays. He's one for two today. 3-1 pitch from Cortez is lined into left field. It's going to dunk in there for a base hit. Falefa will field it. It'll be cut off by LeMahieu. And the bases are loaded with one out for the top of the Rays order. And Yandy Diaz coming up. After the one out single from Mejia. And now that brings up the top of the Rays order. As Margot got the stop sign from the third base coach Williams. Diaz swings and misses there, 0-1. Singled in the first inning. Jimmy Cordero warming up. Here's the 0-1, way upstairs. 1-1. Cortez trying to get out of this. 1-1 pitch to Yandy Diaz. The 1-1. Inside 2-1 on Diaz. One from Cortez. Driven in the air to left field and deep. Falefa gonna turn around and watch it fly out of here. A grand slam for Yandy Diaz, and the Rays make it 5-0. A now 5-0 Rays lead on the grand slam by Yandy Diaz as he muscles one up to the left field seats, and he's gonna put the baby to bed as he crosses home plate. And Nestor Cortez this year for Diaz in 36 games, 319 with 10 home runs. And now Franco fouls it away. 0-1 as Diaz high fives all throughout the dugout. Another look at the grand slam. Cutter in. And Diaz takes it out. 1-1 on Wander Franco. Took the 1-0 lead quickly to make it 5-0. Now Franco at the plate with one out. Check swing foul. 1-2. Showing the muscles as he rounded second base. Jose Siri. He knew it right away. And again, pointed in the muscle up from Yandy Diaz. 1-2 upstairs, 2-2. All smiles in the Rays dugout right now, as it's been all year. They're 30-10. They're 11-7, though, on the road. As Franco fouls it away, still 2-2. And you look at the Rays dugout, putting up the fours. Rocking the baby to bed is Diaz. And Franco fouls another one away, 2-2. Still from Cortez. We saw Jimmy Cordero warming in the bullpen. If another runner gets on, maybe Cortez is done for the day, or they keep going. 2-2 pitch. That shot out into right center field and deep. Bader going back, still back. It's off the track and off the wall. Franco into second with a double, and it's another base hit here in the fifth inning for Tampa Bay, and a one-out double, and that brings Aaron Boone out of the dugout and to the bullpen. Go the Yankees in the fifth. Damage has been done. Grand slam and a double knocks Cortez out of the ballgame in the Bronx. Center, the Ford by FordNow.com. New pitcher in the game for the Yankees. It'll be the right-hander Jimmy Cordero. 14 games this year for the Yankees. 2-1 record with a 3.14 ERA. He does have that 15 strikeouts to 3 walks. He has allowed a home run. 14 and a third innings pitched from the young right-hander. Pitching against the Rays, who have extended their 1-0 lead to 5-0 after the grand slam by Yandy Diaz. Nice. Cortez in the dugout. The 1-0 to Ramirez. Punched out in the air to right. Bowers makes the catch. Tagging and going to third is Franco. Throw to third. Not in time. Franco gets in there safely, as it'll be a flyout. And for the first time in 2 starts this season, Cortez 5 runs allowed. And once in his previous 42 starts for Cortez. First pitch to a Rosarena. Grounded and snared. Oh, what a play by LeMahieu. Throw to first in time. Oh, what a play once again by DJ LeMahieu. And Kevin Cash immediately says he wants to take another look, and for good reason, as a Rosarena looks like he beat it out. And the Rays indeed should win this challenge, as a Rosarena's left foot did beat him to the bag. And a Rosarena doing his sign, telling him he's safe. It would be 6-0 if the run scores. Rosarena pointing to the scoreboard as the umpires take a look at it. And here comes the call.
After review, the call on the field is overturned. The runner is safe. Tampa will retain their challenge.
So the Rays retain the challenge, the run scores, and it will be an infield hit for a Rosarena. And that brings up Isaac Paredes. So Paredes at the plate with 2 outs, and Jimmy Cordero, who was staying warm, is going to be ready to go. Another look we're going to see here with a Rosarena flying right out of the box. Just all speed from Randy, as he immediately said, take another look at it. But again, great credit to DJ LeMahieu, who made that sliding snare attempt at third. As a slider in there, strike one to Jimmy Cordero. So run scores for the race, 6-0. Cordero checks on a Rosarena. Paredes 1-for-2 today with a single. 0-1 pitch coming to Paredes. Line down the first baseline, foul. 0-2. Well, Duracell engineered for more. The number one battery for the New York Yankees. That's what keeps the Yankees going. Today they got to get going. Down 6-0. They do have some comeback wins this year. And in fact, remember, 5 of the Yankees' last 7 wins have been come from behind wins. 0-2. Spiked it in the dirt, 1-2. Well, here for the Yankees, it has been a struggle offensively and not been too great at all. On the ground to LeMahieu. He will fire to get Paredes to end the inning, but the damage indeed has been done. 6-0. Welcome back to Yankee Stadium. Tomorrow, don't forget, Rays batting practice. Today starts tomorrow, 12:30 Eastern time. Game at 1:30, first pitch here in the Bronx. Jake Bowers will lead things off for the Yankees. He's 1-for-1 with a single back in the third inning. Yankees trail 6-0 over the Rays after the grand slam by Yandy Diaz and then the infield hit by Rosarena. 1-1 pitch coming to Jake Bowers from McClanahan, the 1-1. Missed 2-1 on Bowers. Bowers trying to get something going for the Yankees. 2-1. McClanahan misses again outside. 3-1 on Bowers. Kyle Higashioka awaits on deck for New York. 3-1 pitch coming from McClanahan. And he missed. It's ball 4. Bowers works a walk to bring up Higashioka. Second time on base today for Bowers. And now it'll be Kyle Higashioka to the plate. Higashioka has hit safely in 8 of his last 11 and 10 of his 16 games this year. He's hit safely. He did walk in his first at bat. Has not played in each of the last 2 games, but did record a double in the 4th inning on Wednesday against the A's. He is the longest tenured player in the New York Yankees organization, even with Aaron Judge being in the lineup. Higashioka is still the longest tenured Yankee. That was up until Brent Gardner left. McGardy was the longest tenured Yankee. Now it's Higashioka. Seeing the up and downs with this Yankee organization. 1-2 pitch. On the ground, foul. It's 1-2 on Higashioka. Gleyber Torres awaiting on deck for the Yanks. Another 1-2. On the ground, foul again. Still 1-2 on Higashioka. A long 5th inning here in the Bronx. Nine hitters came to the plate for the Rays in the top half of the fifth. 2-2 count on Kyle Higashioka. Bauer's at first. Nobody out in the fifth. Yankees down 6-0 here in the third game of the set. A four games. Higashioka with a fly ball out to left. A Rosarena turns around. This ball is gone. Two-run home run for Kyle Higashioka. And the Yankees strike back. It's 6-2 Rays. Kyle Higashioka with a huge home run for the Yankees. And New York is back in the ballgame. Big, big home run for Higashioka. Just the third hit of the day for the Yankees. And Higgy goes to left field. And here is Gleyber Torres. Takes a strike 0-1. 0-2 with a couple of flyouts today is Torres. Yankees now trail by 4. Torres fouls that one off. Another look at this Higashioka home run. He knew it. Off the bat. 0-2 to Gleyber Torres. Missed it 1-2. So now it'll be the top of the order. With nobody out, Torres, Judge, and Rizzo to bat here in the fifth. 1-2 pitch. Missed up and away, 1-2 to now 2-2 on Gleyber Torres. Well, don't forget, tickets on sale now, Yankees and Red Sox. As Torres punched that one foul, 2-2 again. June 9th through the 11th of June. That'll be a great series. One of those games will be on Fox, the other on YES, and then Friday night would be on YES, Saturday on Fox, Sunday would be on ESPN. 2-2. Torres with a big cut but fouled it off. Still 2-2 on Torres. Two-two count on Torres. Outside, it's 3-2, and Aaron Judge on deck. McClanahan, not a guy that gives up many home runs. Gave up one here, and Kevin Cash, maybe looking towards the Rays bullpen, that has also been very good this year. 3-2, and Torres works a walk. So Torres walks, Aaron Judge coming to the plate. And the pitching coach will come out and talk to Shane McClanahan with Aaron Judge coming to the plate. And warming in the bullpen, Ryan Thompson, a very good reliever for the Rays and a guy that the Yankees struggled to hit against. Aaron Judge 0-for-1 with a walk in the first. Extends another game that he gets on base. Judge walked and fly to center his last time up. So here in the bottom of the fifth inning, Aaron Judge to the plate with a man at first, nobody out. First pitch in there for a strike, 0-1. Judge with 6 home runs on the year. Coming off the IL stint, hasn't hit one since. The 0-1. That's into right center field and deep. Going back, Margot at the wall. On cue for Aaron Judge. A 2-run home run. It's a 2-run goal ball game. 6-4 Tampa Bay. Oh, does that have to feel good for big Aaron Judge. 382 feet. And just like that, we got a 2-run game in the fifth inning. One big swing after another for the Yankees. And it's 6-4 Rays And Shane McClanahan with a deep sigh on his face as Rizzo takes ball 1-1-0. That's the first home run since April 19th against the Angels for Aaron Judge, and that had to feel good. 1-0 in there for a strike, 1-1. Rizzo 0-for-2 with a fielder's choice and a flyout today. 1-1 count on Rizzo. Grounded foul. It's 0-2 on Rizzo. Another look at the home run for Aaron Judge. Going the other way to right center field. One, two. That's lined into left center field. That's going to be in there for a base hit. Cut off by Siri. Rizzo hustling around first in the second with a stand-up double. And the Yankees have come alive here in the fifth. Man, oh, man. And Kevin Cash, maybe time to pull the big fella. McClanahan out of the game, it looks like. Jose Siri fielding it. And Anthony Rizzo smelling the opportunity for the Yankees. McClanahan exits. It's a two-run game in the fifth inning. Aaron Judge, Kyle Higashioka, the big swings in the fifth. Rizzo's at second. LeMahieu's coming up next for the Yankees. Well, welcome back to Yankees baseball. And yes, Aaron Judge, big two-run home run. Kyle Higashioka, big two-run home run. Now Ryan Thompson in the game. Bottom of the fifth inning here in New York. First pitch is 1-0 on DJ LeMahieu. First start allowing 3-plus runs this season. Last five batters reached safely. That's 4 runs. Ryan Thompson, the new pitcher for the Rays. So Thompson, the new pitcher, 1-1 count. Well, 1-1 count with the new pitcher, Ryan Thompson, against LeMahieu. Rizzo is at second. Pitch outside, 1-2 on Tom from Thompson. And a Yankee at bat for DJ LeMahieu with a huge run at second base. Yankees trailing by 2 runs. The 2-1. Grounded up the middle. Franco Fields. He'll fire to first. In time to get LeMahieu. Rizzo moves to third. And that will bring up Harrison Bader. Season versus the Yankees. He's pitched in 5 games. He's got a 6.75 ERA. Does this Rays bullpen with 5 home runs allowed. But against every other team, they have been phenomenal. Harrison Bader to the plate. Rizzo's at third. Slider and a swinging and a miss from Harrison Bader. Bader 0-for-2 with a lineout and a strikeout today. That's popped up. Mejia behind the plate. And he makes the catch for out number 2. Fly out to the catcher. So two away. Here is Connor Falefa now. And he is going to be pinched hit. Will be Oswaldo Cabrera. So Cabrera, the switch hitter, is going to come in to pinch hit for Connor Falefa. And Ryan Thompson will get a talking to from the pitching coach. Give him the scouting report on Cabrera. So Cabrera coming in here in the fifth. He'll most likely take over left field also. Will Cabrera. Runner at third, two outs. Cabrera fresh off the bench for the New York Yankees. Higashioka with the big home run. Judge with the big home run. Rizzo doubled. It's 6-4 Rays. After coming into this inning, the Yankees were down 6-0. First pitch to Oswaldo Cabrera is a sinker in there, strike one. Cabrera's gone off to a rough start, just batting under 200 for the Yankees. 1-0 on Oswaldo Cabrera. Slider missed his low, 1-1. A long fifth inning between these two teams. Three total home runs in this inning. Total between the top half and the bottom half of the fifth. A grand slam by Yandy Diaz in the top of the fifth. A long two home runs for the Yankees. Higashioka to left. Judge the other way to right. 2-1 on Cabrera. Is a swing and a miss. Beautiful slider by Ryan Thompson. Beautiful pitch. Take another look at it. The movement on that slider. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Two-run Rays lead here in the fifth. Cabrera calls time. Trying to take off the timing to Thompson as he was trying to get the right pitch. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. We'll do it again. Bottom of the fifth inning, Yankees down by two. 2-2. In the air, right field. Walls going out. Calling off Margot. He calls off Walls when Margot makes the catch, but not before the damage done. Kyle Higashioka makes it a four-run game, and then Aaron Judge, his first home run since April 19th, makes it a two-run game in the fifth in the Bronx.
Hey everybody, Bob Lorenz with your Audi update. Let's check on the Mariners taking on the Tigers in Detroit. Top of the third, Jared Kelnick off Alex Fiedo out to right. His eighth of the year as the Mariners go up 2-0. And then top of the fourth, Teoscar Hernandez, his eighth as well. Seattle leading that one 3-0 over Detroit. They're in the top half of the eighth. Fellas, back to you.
Well, here is Taylor Walls. He'll lead off the top of the sixth inning against Jimmy Cordero. 6-4 Rays lead, top of the sixth inning in the Bronx. Yankees have made it a ball game once again. The comeback kids have done it again. 1-0 in there for a strike. It's 1-1. 1-1 count on Jimmy Cordero. 6-4 Rays lead, comeback kids have made it a two-run game. The 1-1 in there for a strike. 1-2. Oswaldo Cabrera. Came in to pinch hit for Connor Falefa in the sixth. He'll stay out there in left field. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Coming to Jimmy Cordero is strike three looking. Walls down on strikes and talking to the home plate umpire Sean Barber about it for out number one. And here is a look around the majors. Cedric Mullins hit for the cycle last night in the win against the Pirates. Jose Altuve began his rehab assignment last night with the injured right thumb from the World Baseball Classic. When he injured that thumb. So here is Manuel Margot, the batter. Walked his last at bat. That's fouled away 0-1. Now 0-2 on Margot. Yankees trail by two here in the sixth. Cordero set, and now time called by Margot. It'll be Walls, Margot, and Jose Siri here in the sixth against Cordero. As the 0-2 pitch coming. Ripped foul, still 0-2. 0-for-1 with a walk is Margot today. Top of the sixth inning. One out. O2 pitch coming from Cordero. Is a swing and a miss. Got him. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the sixth inning for Cordero. Two away. And that'll bring up Jose Siri. Another look at the slider for the strikeout. Beautiful. Beautiful pitch there by Manuel Margot. So here is Jose Siri, the batter. Grounded foul. 0-1. Siri, 0-for-1 with a walk in the fifth. He was on base for that Yandy Diaz grand slam in the fifth inning. Ground ball up the middle. Torres and Volpe. It's Volpe makes the play and fires to first to get Jose Siri for the final out. A quick inning from Cordero. Bottom of the order for the Yanks coming up. Well, welcome back to Yankee Stadium. Let's take a look at the FanDuel current run totals. Odds obviously to change, but the over 13.5. Don't forget, new customers bet $5, get $150 in bonus bets guaranteed. That's FanDuel for you. Jimmy Cordero talking to Yankees starter Domingo Germán after a really good sixth inning. Eat some ice cream out of the mini Yankee helmet. A Giants fan. Always good to see them around. Giants rookie camp officially underway. Anthony Volpe leads things off here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Squares the bunt. He does. And it's going to be a tough play. Paredes is not a barehanded, but not being able to make the play. And Volpe is going to reach on an infield single. So Anthony Volpe with a bunt for a base hit. Paredes came right in, but could not make the barehand play. It would have been a tough play either way to get the speedy Anthony Volpe. And now it is Jake Bowers to the plate. He's been on base twice today, a single and a walk, and then scored on the Kyle Higashioka home run. Tying run at the plate in Bowers, bottom of the sixth inning. Runner goes. Mejia's throw to second. It's a good one to throw. Not in time. Volpe steals the bag. Francisco Mejia looking at the Braves dugout, maybe to get another look. Here is that other look. And it was a very close play at second. Volpe got a good jump. Really good throw by Mejia, though. And this is going to probably be the best angle. Glove there, tag there. tough call, and it's going to be under review for the Yankees. And here is another look. It is so bang bang. That slotty mitt, does it touch before Franco's glove touches the left hip of Volpe? That's what the question here is going to be. Does Volpe's left hip get touched by the glove before Franco is able to make the tag? Such bang bang. Now it's going to be obviously to overrule it, of course, for the Yankees. So, very, very close play. A lot of different angles to look at it. It was a perfect throw and a perfect spot for Mejia to throw it to. Great tag by Franco. The question is the sliding mitt of Anthony Volpe already on the base by the time that Franco is able to make the play? Here's the call.
After review, the call on the field stands. The runner is safe. Tampa Bay will lose their challenge.
That's the 12th stolen base this year for Anthony Volpe. He's tied for second in the American League now, and the lead is for Kevin Cash, lost his challenge. So now it's 1-0 on Jake Bowers and a stolen base for Volpe, who's now at second base. 1-0 on Bowers. Check this swing and went around. 1-1. Jake Bowers, remember, mentioned one for one today with a walk. That was back in that fifth inning. Volpe's at second. The 1-1 lined into left field. The running grab by Arozarena to make the catch. It'll keep Volpe at second. One away. Bowers goes the other way, but wasn't able to get it down. And Arozarena making the grab. So now a pinch hitter will come to the plate for Higashioka, who just hit that home run in the fifth inning against McClanahan. It'll now be Willie Calhoun who comes to the plate for New York. Interesting move here by Aaron Boone. And again, the pitching coach comes out to talk to Ryan Thompson here in the sixth. One on, one out, Volpe at the plate. Volpe at second. Calhoun is at the plate. Top of the Yankee order on deck in Gleyber Torres. And then, of course, Aaron Judge would follow him. Here on this Saturday afternoon in the Bronx, the Yankees were down 6-0 at one point, have now made it 6-4 with a couple of home runs off the bat of Higashioka. And then Aaron Judge, who also went deep back of the fifth, last inning. Ron Marinaccio starting to warm in that Yankee bullpen. So here's Willie Calhoun against Ryan Thompson. First pitch missed way outside. 1-0. Well, Willie Calhoun for the Yankees. To look and see what he's done. He's reached base in 11 of his 13 starts. This year, Calhoun lifts this to left center field. Arozarena calling off Siri. Arozarena makes the catch. Volpe will stay at second. So Calhoun flies out, and that will bring up Gleyber Torres after the leadoff infield bunt single from Volpe, who then stole second in scoring position and nobody out. Now two outs for Torres. Takes a strike. Colin Poche warming in the Rays bullpen. Torres thought that was going to be maybe a pitch clock violation. Not sure exactly what happened when he just kind of stepped off and it was called a strike. So 0-2 on Torres. Missed outside 1-2. I'm sorry, 1-1 on Torres. Score sheet was wrong. So 1-1 count on Torres. Thompson steps off, checks on Volpe at second. Well, if Torres could get on, it'll bring up Aaron Judge. But a 1-1 count first from Ryan Thompson to Gleyber Torres. Volpe takes off. And a stolen base for Anthony Volpe. 13 for 13 on the year. His fifth steal of third this season. And he's tied for most with Ruiz. And Anthony Volpe once again stealing the bag. Five times he's stolen third base this season. 2-1 on Torres. Ball gets away from Mejia. Volpe's coming home. He's going to score. That's why you steal third base. It's a one-run game. Anthony Volpe scores on the wild pitch. The very next pitch after he steals third base, Thompson throws it to the backstop and Volpe scores. Great base running by Volpe. You saw Torres helping him out. And a smile from Anthony Volpe as it's a wild pitch and the Yankees have pulled to within one. 3-1 fouled away by Torres. And that is now 3-2 on Torres. Aaron Judge on deck. Yankees have scored in back-to-back innings now against the Rays. 3-2. Throws behind Torres. And he walks. And Aaron Judge coming to the plate. And Ryan Thompson talking to the home plate umpire. So here is Aaron Judge. Homered for the first time since April 19th against the Angels. Last inning with the two-run home run. Made it 6-4. And now with a chance for the Yankees here in the sixth. First and runner on. Volpe scored on the wild pitch. It's a one-run game. Judge goes way around. And that was in on the hands of Judge. And a smile knows that wanted to get out of that. That was not looking good for the Yankees outfielder. Signed a long, long-term deal with the Yankees this offseason. 0-1 pitch to Judge. On the ground, foul 0-2. Two-hitter in the Yankee lineup for Judge. Gleyber Torres, who worked that walk, is at first. The 0-2 coming from Ryan Thompson. One-two pitch coming to Aaron Judge. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Judge in the air to left field and deep. He do it again. He did do it again. Second home run for Judge. It's another two-run home run. He hasn't homered since April 19th. He goes, the long drought ends today, and he's not just hit one. He has hit two against the Rays. Back-to-back innings for Judge. Back-to-back home runs in those innings for Judge. Yankees lead 7-6. Another huge home run for Judge. His now eighth home run of the year. and the American League MVP a year ago. Rizzo's going to bunt. Thompson can't field it cleanly. Anthony Rizzo with a bunt single. And you see Aaron Judge's reaction from the Yankee dugout. And another look at the second home run of the day for Judge. Watch this one. Pointing to the Yankee dugout. He knew it right away. And all smiles once again in the Bronx here for the Yankees. Anthony Rizzo at first now. DJ LeMahieu to the plate. He squares to bunt. Pulls it back. 0-1. That's two bunt singles for the Yankees here in the sixth inning. Ryan Thompson about to throw his 30th pitch of this game. The 0-1. Outside 1-1. Another look at this Judge home run. Here's a side view of it. And a look at the Yankee dugout. And everybody knew it right away when Big Aaron Judge hit that. And it landed 7-6 Yankee lead. Pitch to LeMay, used a strike. It's 1-2. Well, for Aaron Judge, that's the 29th career multi-homer game. That's tied fifth most in Yankees all-time history, along with Alex Rodriguez. 1-2 to LeMahieu. Missed outside. 2-2. Well, it all started with the Anthony Volpe bunt that got past Paredes as he tried to barehand it. Then Volpe stole second. Bowers flied out. And then Calhoun flied out. Volpe then stole third. Wild pitch in the at-bat to Torres that scored Volpe. Torres walked. Judge hit the home run. That's where we stand now here in the sixth inning. 7-6 Yankee lead. And time called by LeMahieu. What a turnaround for the Yankees after being down 6-0 entering the fifth inning. The bats have come to life. 3-2 pitch coming to DJ LeMahieu with Bader on deck. 3-2. Inside, he walked him. Ball four, and that is going to do it for Ryan Thompson. Kevin Cash coming out of the dugout. And once again, the damage done. Aaron Judge, two homers today. Thompson's going to exit. Guerrero coming in. First and second, trouble on the bases as Thompson exits. He's responsible for both of them. And thanks to that guy, Aaron Judge. We'll be right back. Back here at Yankee Stadium. Don't forget, opening weekend coverage, New York Liberty. They're back Friday, 7 Eastern time on the Yes app and My9. And then on Sunday here on Yes. Well, Javi Guerrero will come in to pitch. The Rays bullpen now against the Yankees in six games this season. 7.36 ERA against New York. But against any other team, they got a 2.66 ERA. And now the Yankees once again threatening with first and second. Two out and Harrison Bader at the plate. Inside on Bader, 0-1-0. Rizzo's at first on the infield bunt single. LeMahieu walked. Thompson exited. And now Bader, who's 0-3. 1-0 coming from Guerrero. Low and outside, 2-0. Around Marinaccio. Once again, he's going to continue to warm in the Yankee bullpen. 3-0 now on Bader. 3-0 on Bader. And Cabrera due on deck for the Yankees. 3-0 pitch. Swinging on 3-0, and he fouls it away. 3-1. 7-6. Yankees lead in the sixth. Ron Marinaccio most likely to come out and pitch the seventh inning for New York. 3-1 pitch coming to Guerrero from Guerrero. Low, and it's ball four. Bader with a walk. Bases are loaded as Bader walks. And the Yankees have the bases loaded, two outs with Oswaldo Cabrera coming to the plate and a mound visit from the pitching coach. And he's just trying to calm down the young right-hander with the bases loaded and two outs in the sixth inning. Oswaldo Cabrera, the only batter to not hit in this inning yet for the Yankees. Cabrera at the plate. Fly down in the fifth inning. And here we go. 7-6 Yankee lead and a chance to add more to it. And wouldn't the Yankees love to do that? They'd love to add a little more. First pitch. Just missed 1-0. Rizzo at third. LeMahieu at second. Bader is at first. Two outs. Cabrera at the plate. Big situation. The 1-0. Is a strike, 1-1 on Cabrera. Remember, Cabrera came in to pinch hit for Connor Falefa back in the fifth inning. Here's the 1-1 coming to Oswaldo Cabrera. 1-1. Gassed him at 100 miles an hour, but it missed low and away. 2-1 on Cabrera. And Anthony Volpe on deck. Volpe does have now a grand slam in his career, as he did it against the A's. 2-1 pitch. Lined into right field. It gets past the glove of Walls and into right field. Margot's going to throw home. Rizzo scores. Throw to the plate. LeMahieu's going to score. It's a two-run RBI single for Oswaldo Cabrera. Yankees lead 9-6. What a fifth and sixth inning for the Yankees. A fastball that Cabrera saw coming and lined it into right field past the glove of Walls. Margot throws home, but it was not in time to get LeMahieu. Another look at it to make sure. And indeed, DJ LeMahieu is in there safely. Another huge RBI. Rizzo scored. LeMahieu scored. Here's Volpe. Runners on first and third with two outs in the sixth. And Volpe, who already has gotten a hit in this inning with a bunt single, it started everything in the sixth. Complete turnaround for the Yankees. The 1-0. Swing and a miss. 1-1 on Volpe. Well, Volpe started everything off with this bunt. 1-1. 1-2 on Volpe. A total turnaround for the Yankees in this game. It was 6-0 entering the fifth inning for New York to bat in the bottom of the fifth. 1-2 coming to Anthony Volpe. Popped up. Foul territory, long run for Diaz, but it hits the seats foul, and Volpe will get another chance. Well, the grand slam came in the top of the fifth from Yandy Diaz. Then Rosarena had that infield single, made it 6-0. And then everything turned around from there. Quick inning in the top of the sixth from Cordero. Yankees scored 4 runs in the fifth inning. They have now scored 5 here in the sixth to make it a 9-6 game. 1-2 coming from Guerrero. Swing and a miss, got him. Volpe strikes out, but not before the damage done. It all started with the bunt, then the stolen base of Volpe. Then he stole third. Then he stole the home on a wild pitch. Then Aaron Judge. Why not do it again? 9-6 Yankees through 6 in the Bronx in the third game of the series. Yankees Gold Glove third base. Here today, some spectacular defensive plays. There's one of them, and one of very few, as a meeting on the mound right now, and they're going to try and maybe fix up the mound a little bit for Ron Marinaccio. Well, they're going to have to get the grounds crew out here to do exactly that. And Marinaccio, kind of, you see that looks like maybe a divot or something that has to be air blown out, and yeah, everyone's going to go away real quick. They're going to blow whatever that is away. Probably wet it a little bit. Yep, there you go. Dry it up. Put some more dirt down. Exactly how it's done. Great job by the grounds crew. Getting the job done really quick. Efficient. Doing what has to be done. Made the ground crews here in the Yankee Stadium. They know what they're doing. They do it all so well every day and for every game that's played here at Yankee Stadium. It's all done so well. Well, you know something else that's done well? It's the Yankees and their comeback ability. So far, the amount of times they did it last year, the amount of times they've done it now. So Ron Marinaccio will continue to warm up. Let's take a look at the numbers of Marinaccio as he hits the mound on this beautiful day. Let's take another look inside as the top of the seventh inning. 4 runs in the bottom of the fifth for the Yankees, 5 in the bottom of the sixth. And the new catcher will be Jose Trevino for the Yankees after Calhoun pinched hit in the sixth. Well, Marinaccio comes in. You see Gerrit Cole talking in the Yankee dugout. Got the fresh cut going for Cole. So Ron Marinaccio is going to come in pitching with a 3-run lead now here for the Yankees in the top of the seventh. First pitch coming to Marinaccio, from Marinaccio to Mejia, who switches from batting from the left side over to the right. The 0-1. Well, for the Yankees, Ron Marinaccio, 2.70 ERA. And with this Yankees team, Marinaccio, as that's in the center field, a base hit for Francisco Mejia. So the number 9 hitter with a leadoff single. And a chance once again here for the Rays. And here's Yandy Diaz. Couple of hits in this one, a single in the first inning, but the big blow back in the fifth, the grand slam. That's the big swing. Up and in from Marinaccio. Yandy Diaz hit the deck on that one. Another look at it. And that's not something you really want to see all too often. But here's the 1-0 in there for a strike. 1-1. Back to the fifth inning. This is Yandy Diaz doing Yandy Diaz things. And going yard for his 10th home run of the season. That misses outside 2-1. Javi Guerrera, the other pitcher that came in for the Rays. 2-1 on Yandy Diaz. And that hit him. So Marinaccio in a little bit of trouble. First and second, nobody out. And Wander Franco coming up. Yankees hold a 3-run lead with Franco at the plate. And a slider that just never slid. And a mound visit from the pitching coach, Matt Blake. Well, has only hit one batter up until that point, and now it's going to be Wander Franco, who comes into the game 1-for-3 today and looking to try and do some damage. First and second, nobody out. Ron Marinaccio trying to wiggle out of this trouble. 3-run Yankee lead. That's a strike, 0-1 to Wander Franco. Franco and then Ramirez is waiting on deck here for the Rays. One pitch coming from Marinaccio. Missed a little outside, 1-1. Franco signed an early long-term deal with the Rays after his rookie season. The Rays knew that they wanted this young star. 1-1. Just missed 2-1 on Franco. You saw Clay Holmes warming in the Yankee bullpen earlier, a few moments ago. 2-1 count on Franco. Grounded weakly to Rizzo. Flips sidearm and gets Franco as he got it to Marinaccio just in time. And that is going to bring up Harold Ramirez as he is going to face the youngster, Marinaccio, who's coming out, it looks like. Clay Holmes is going to come in to pitch for the Yankees. Could he get the job done and get out of the jam with one out here in the seventh? Welcome back to Yankee Stadium. Let's take a look at the Audi electric moment. And, well, there's only really one, and it was Aaron Judge. One home run to right center field, and then he goes to left field to give the Yankees the lead and re-energize the crowd here in the Bronx. The New York Yankees have been rolling right now since those home runs from Judge. Well, now it's Clay Holmes into the game. He's 4-of-6 in save opportunities this year. But for Clay Holmes, it has been a bumpy road. First time to the plate for the pinch hitter. And it is Josh Lowe. So Lowe pinch hitting for Ramirez. Oh and one. No one from Holmes. In there for a strike. 0-2. To Lowe. Second and third. One man out. Josh Lowe, the pinch hitter. Yandy Diaz at second. Mejia is at third. 0-2 coming here from Clay Holmes. Fouled it away. 0-2. Well, let's go back to last night against Michael King. Josh Lowe went the other way to left field and hit the home run against King, now facing Holmes. 0-2. Missed outside, 1-2 on Lowe. Once again, Mejia at third, Diaz at second. First base open with one out in the seventh. But Holmes does not want to walk him to bring up a Rosarena. But the base is loaded. 1-2. Swing and a miss. Huge strikeout for Holmes. Lowe strikes out. Monster strikeout. And here comes a Rosarena, who's been on base twice today and is 2-for-3. Now Clay Holmes trying to get one more big out. And it's going to be a Rosarena that he's going to have to do it to. That's a strike, 0-1. Two singles, a run, and an RBI for a Rosarena today. One of those singles scored the sixth run of the game for the Rays. That's when it was 6-0. 0-1, up and in, 1-1 on a Rosarena. One-one pitch coming to Randy Arozarena. Holmes deals. The 1-1. Up the middle, it's going to get through for a base hit. One run scores. Two runs are going to score. It's a two-run RBI single for Randy Arozarena. And the Rays have pulled to within one here in the seventh. Another big hit from Randy Arozarena. Two runs score on the RBI. Diaz, Mejia, both score. And that brings up Isaac Paredes. But there's going to be a pinch hitter. And it's going to be Brandon Lau. So Brandon Lau, the lefty, going to come in to pinch hit for Paredes with two outs here in the seventh. Batting 179 is Lau. Clay Holmes' struggles continue. Not allowing runs. Allows two here in the seventh. Both of those runs belong to Ron Marinaccio. 1-0 pitch coming to Lau. The 1-0. Lined into center field. There's another base hit over the glove of Volpe. A pinch hit single for Lowe. And the Yankees once again trying to get out of a jam with Clay Holmes, who's now giving up back-to-back hits for the Rays. And it's first and second, two outs. And Taylor Walls coming to the plate. So Walls to the plate, another lefty. RBI single in the second inning, and a chance at an RBI with really good speed at second. Pitch from Holmes. On the ground to first, Rizzo fields, steps on the bag, and that will do it to end the inning. We're going to stay right here to honor America in the Bronx. 9-8 Yankee lead.
But we'll stay right here as we honor America in the Bronx. Ladies and gentlemen, will you rise and remove your caps and please direct your attention to the area behind home plate as the New York Yankees welcome an honored military guest. United States Army Private William Herbert from Farmingdale, New York, who served in the Korean War. The Yankees say thank you for your sacrifice and service to our nation.
It's time for your Ford Studio update. Bob and Jack with you. A pitcher's duel. It is not today in the Bronx. An exciting slugfest. Absolutely is.
In that fifth and sixth inning, the Yankees explode for 9 runs, Bob. That included 3 home runs, 2 by Judge. But do you know what preceded every home run? A walk. It's important to know when to swing at strikes. It's also important to know when a pitcher isn't challenging you and take the walk. If the Yankees can get these final 6 outs, most thrilling win of the season.
I said no pitcher's duel. It is from here on out. We'll see you guys on the postgame.
Well, let's take a look at the game summary. Let's start with this. It was 1-0 Tampa Bay, then 5 runs in the top of the fifth inning, 4 in the bottom of the fourth in the fifth inning for the Yankees, a quick inning from Cordero in the top of the sixth, and then 5 runs in the bottom half for the Yankees, including another 2-run home run by Judge, 2 more runs scoring for the Rays in the top of the seventh. Here's Jake Bowers to lead things off, the new pitcher is Jalen Beeks for the Rays with a 6.00 ERA. And Jake Bowers at the plate. Oh, and 2 on Bowers. Bowers 1-for-2 with a single, a walk, and a flyout. Did he go around? No, he did not. Well, back at Yankee Stadium, the 1-2 on Jake Bowers. Taylor Walls moves over to third on the substitution. And Bowers fouls that one away, 1-2 here in the bottom of the seventh. 9-8 Yankee lead. Bowers 1-for-2, single walk and run scored on the Higashioka home run. The 1-2 coming from Jalen Beeks, the lefty. Another one fouled away. Still 1-2. One and two coming here from Beeks. The 1-2 in the dirt. 2-2 on Bowers. Jose Trevino is going to be on deck. He took over for Calhoun, who took over for Higashioka. 2-2 coming again from Beeks. And another foul ball. Well, don't forget Wendy's breakfast deal, croissant and small potato. Get your Wendy's breakfast today. And get ready for Yankees baseball today. Two balls, two strikes to the leadoff man, Bowers. 2-2. Swing and a miss, got him. Bowers strikes out for the out. One away. Let's take a look back at the trivia question. Who are the only two players to hit 20-plus home runs and steal 20-plus bases in a season at the age of 38 or older? Paul O'Neill and Gary Sheffield. Paul O'Neill in 2001, 21 homers, 22 stolen bases, and Sheffield in 2007. So here is Jose Trevino in his first at-bat of the game, batting 214 with three home runs on the year, 11 RBIs. The 1-0 in there for a strike, 1-1 on Trevino. Well, it could be if the Yankees could get the last six outs. Very, very exciting. Pitch grounded to the second baseman low, and that's out number two here in the seventh. And Gleyber Torres to the plate. Well, the only guys left on the Yankee bench, Cabrera is done. Calhoun's been used. So is Trevino. So the only one left would be Aaron Hicks. Yankees lead by one here in the seventh. Here is Gleyber Torres. Swings at the first pitch and loops it to right field. Manuel Margot is there, and he's got it to make the catch, and that'll do it. A quick 1-2-3 inning to go to the eighth. The bottom of the order for the Rays due up. Don't forget, here at Yankee Stadium, you have a hero. Nominate your everyday hero. They can win a 2023 Hyundai Tucson. Scan the QR code or visit HyundaiSaluteToHeroes.com. Your Hyundai Salute to Heroes. Scan the QR code to enter your hero. Well, Clay Holmes is going to come into the game and stay into the game here in the eighth. He came in the seventh for Marinaccio. And the new batter is going to be Luke Rayleigh, who's going to pinch hit for Manuel Margot. So here is the 0-1 from Clay Holmes. Check swing on a slider. Did he go around? Yes, he did. Strike two. Let's take a look at the Rays bench. Josh Lowe, Brandon Lowe, Luke Rayleigh are all out. The only other guy left they have is Christian Bethencourt, the other catcher for the Rays. The 0-2. Missed outside 1-2. One, two pitch coming to Luke Rayleigh. The 1-2. Low, and it's 2-2 on Rayleigh. Clay Holmes, who has struggled at times in this season, getting out of trouble and forcing trouble. 2-2 pitch. Lined in a right center field. There's a base hit for Rayleigh. A pinch hit single to bring up Jose Siri in the tying run aboard. Here in the eighth inning. So Rayleigh with another base hit for the Rays. And that brings up Jose Siri, who's 0-2. Here in the top of the eighth inning, one-run Yankee lead. Siri 0-2 with a walk in the fifth and then scored in this game. Back in the fifth. The 1-0. 1-0 is popped up to right field. Shallow right. Bowers coming in. He makes the catch. He's got out number one. So one away here is Mejia. 2-for-3, two singles, two runs in the game. Albert Abreu and Wandy Peralta starting to warm in the Yankee pen. So two guys warming in the bullpen. This one gets away from Trevino. Rayleigh's going to go to second. So Luke Rayleigh's going to get to second on a wild pitch that was off the glove of Trevino on a high sinker from Holmes. And on the tying run is in scoring position. One oh from Holmes is a big swing and a miss from Mejia. 1-1 on a slider. Clay Holmes with a runner at second now. 1-1 pitch. Grounded foul. 1-2 on Mejia. One and two count on Francisco Mejia, top of the eighth inning. Yankees hold a one-run lead. 0-2. Swing and a miss, got him. Two away. Big, big strikeout for Clay Holmes. And that's going to bring up Yandy Diaz. Big slider there for Holmes. And Matt Blake is going to come out and talk to Clay Holmes about what he's going to do with Yandy Diaz. Diaz has hit a grand slam in this game. He was hit by a pitch and scored. He singled in the first inning. He's been on base three times today. He's also, with that grand slam, has been huge. Well, don't forget, the Yes Network, check out and follow Yes Network on TikTok, where everything for the Yankees starts on TikTok. So Holmes versus Diaz. Diaz, as we said, 2-for-3, single grand slam hit by a pitch. Tying run at second base in scoring position for the Rays. The top of the Rays lineup at the plate in Yandy Diaz. How does Clay Holmes attack? First pitch is a strike. 0-1 on a sinker. Big first pitch there from Holmes. 0-1 from Clay Holmes to Diaz. The 0-1. Sweeper in there for a strike. 0-2. Big pitch coming from Clay Holmes. Yankee fans on their feet here in the Bronx. The 0-2. Missed outside. 1-2 on Diaz. Missed with the slider there. And again, the Yankee fans on their feet. Getting loud in the Bronx. Ready for the 1-2 pitch. The 1-2. Fouled it off and it hits Trevino. And staying alive is Diaz. And did that hit Trevino or did that just hit the glove? Well, that's going to be, say it's foul. Trevino's going to stick in there and stick tough. Holmes going to give him some time. So 1-2 on Diaz. Clay Holmes trying to pitch out of the trouble he got himself into. But the Yankee fans behind him here in the eighth. 1-2 coming. Fouled away again from Diaz. He stays alive. Still 1-2. Well, Holmes at 27 pitches, about to throw pitch number 28. Here to Diaz. Another 1-2. And fouled off again. That one looked like it hit the face mask of Trevino. And it did. So it hits the face mask of Trevino. And we're going to do the 1-2 count one more time. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Tying run at second for Clay Holmes. Trying to pitch out of it. The 1-2. Missed outside. 2-2. For Yandy Diaz. And Juan DeFranco is on deck. Two, two coming from Clay Holmes. 2-2. Missed outside. 3-2. And a great battle here by Yandy Diaz. Was behind in the count. Now ahead of it. 3 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Braley at third. Excuse me, at second. 3-2 pitch. Strike three. Got him looking. Diaz doesn't love the call. Clay Holmes definitely does. And Holmes pitches out of the leadoff hit. We go to the bottom of the eighth. 1-run Yankee lead. Welcome back to Yankee Stadium. Let's take another look at that last pitch from Clay Holmes. That was called a strike. As Judge swings and misses there, 0-1. Aaron Judge, 2 home runs in this game. Luke Raley, 0-1. Or excuse me, 1-1, and takes over in right field for the Rays. Well, most likely Clay Holmes' game is done. 29th career multi-homer game for Judge. Seeking his first career 3-homer game. And imagine how loud this place gets if he could go deep one more time. And he's going to have to do it against the lefty Beeks. 0-2 is away, 1-2. 1-2 count on the Yankee captain. 1-2. Strike three looking. Judge down on strikes. One away. And that brings up Rizzo. Just at the bottom of the zone. That was more of a strike than that last strike to Diaz. And that brings up Rizzo. Rizzo 2-for-4. And for Anthony Rizzo, last time he bunted for a base hit. That was in the sixth inning. He's doubled and singled and scored in this game. The 0-1 in the dirt, 1-1 for Rizzo. Well, if the Yankees could get 3 more outs in this game, how good would the Yankees feel after coming back last night from behind and trying to come back here and hold on to this 1-run lead in the eighth? The 1-1. Swing and a miss for Rizzo, 1-2. Well, here for the Yankees, huge, huge 9th inning coming up. Josh Lowe, Arozarena, and Brandon Lau all coming up in the 9th. And most likely they're going to face Wandy Peralta. 1-2 pitch coming to Anthony Rizzo. Missed outside, 2-2 on Rizzo. What a game it's been here on this Saturday afternoon in the Bronx. 2-2 to Anthony Rizzo. Missed low, 3-2. Count is full with DJ LeMahieu on deck for the Yankees. LeMahieu 1-for-3 today. Singled and walked. 3-2. Fouled away there, and it's still 3-2. We'll do up in the 9th. We just said it. Franco, Low, and Arozarena. Those are going to be the 3 that Peralta most likely faces. 2 of them are going to bat from the right side. Low will bat from the left. 3-2 count on Anthony Rizzo. Umpire called time. 3-2, one out. Jalen Beeks deals. Fouled off again. 3-2 again coming from Jalen Beeks. Anthony Rizzo once again battling here against the Rays pitching staff. Payoff pitch from Beeks. Is lined into center field, a base hit for Rizzo. Third hit of the game for Rizzo. And the Yankees with a man on for DJ LeMahieu. Well, let's take a look at the Delta scoreboard. Bottom of the ninth inning, Reds and the Marlins down in Miami. That's a good one as well. Coming down to the wire, Twins just got underway after the rain delay in Minnesota. They're in the top of the third inning. Braves over the Blue Jays 2-0, top of the fourth. Mariners beat the Tigers 5-0. And the Reds are now final 6-5 win over the Marlins. 0-1 is in there for a strike. It's 0-2 on DJ LeMahieu. Rizzo at first, one out in the eighth. Yankees lead by a run. 0-2. Check swing. Did he go around? Yes, he did. Said first base umpire Mike Muslinski. And that's a strikeout for LeMahieu. And that'll bring up Harrison Bader. As LeMahieu did go around. So Bader to the plate. He's 0-for-3 with a walk. And that walk came in that long sixth inning for the Yankees. Bottom of the eighth, two out. Bader takes a strike, going one. Batting .351 is Bader this year since coming back from the injury. 0-1. Blew it by him at 95. Strike two, 0-2. I'll stream Yankees baseball on the S app, presented by T-Mobile. Don't forget to follow the Yankees on TikTok. Everything happens on TikTok. 0-2. Check swing foul. Still 0-2 on Harrison Bader. Another long relief outing for these two bullpens today. Holmes threw about 30 pitches. Thompson threw about 30 pitches. And now Beeks has thrown about 30 pitches. Pitch 31, back up the middle. Brandon Lau will step on second, and that'll do it. Well, does Wandy Peralta have it to finish the job? 2-3-4 for the Rays in the ninth coming up. Well, back in the Bronx, Wandy Peralta. This is last night against the Rays. He got Lau. He got Ramirez. Then he got Margot for the final out of the ball game. Wandy Peralta going to try and do it again here in the ninth. Yankees lead by one. Rays 8-12-0. Yankees 9-10-0. Here in the top of the ninth inning. 2, 3, and 4 hitters for the Rays. Peralta coming in. 1-for-2 in save opportunities this year. And Wandy Peralta. Could he finish the job for the Yankees? He's going to look to do it here in the ninth. Bronco leads it off. First pitch is a strike, and it's 0-1 on Peralta. 188 ERA from Wandy. On the ground is short. Anthony Volpe across the diamond in time to get the first out here in the ninth. The WB Mason postgame show after the final out right here on the YES Network and, of course, on the YES app. Live stats, full analysis, and highlights of the game in this action-packed slugfest here in the Bronx. Well, Christian Bethencourt's going to pinch hit for Josh Lowe. And Bethencourt will come in to face Peralta in the ninth. So here we go. Top of the ninth, one out. Bethencourt, the pinch hitter. Swing and a miss there. Strike one. 0-1 on Bethencourt. Swing and a miss. 0-2 from Wandy Peralta. Peralta looking for the save opportunity. He's two outs away and one strike away from getting a huge, huge out in Bethencourt. 0-2 from Peralta. O2 pitch coming in the dirt, 1-2. Wandy Peralta. Seems like he's been the guy right now here for the Yankees. The 1-2 again to Bethencourt is chopped, fouled away. Still 1-2 on Bethencourt. Peralta two outs away. 1-2. Fouled off again. Still 1-2. Bethencourt battling here against Peralta in this top of the ninth inning. Nestor Cortes Jr. started it all. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. He got him. Two down here in the ninth. Monster strikeout of Bethencourt. Rays are down to their final out, and it's coming to Randy Arozarena to the plate. Arozarena versus Peralta. Pitch outside, 1-0. Against lefties, he's at 27 at-bats. Bats 375 home runs. Against righties, 304 with 5 home runs. The 1-0. In there for a strike, it's 1-1. All the Yankee fans here in New York are ready. 1-1 down the left field line, foul. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Top of the ninth, Yankees lead by one run. Yankee fans on their feet in the ninth. Quick pitch for Peralta. Fouled it away, 1-2. Peralta tried to fool Arozarena there with the quick pitch. 1-2 coming from Wandy Peralta. Big pitch. 1-2. Missed low, 2-2. So 2-2 on Peralta. From Peralta to Arozarena. On the ground, foul. Still 2-2. Aaron Judge, the DH. The real difference maker in this game. 2-2. In the dirt, it's 3-2. On to Arozarena. Brandon Lau on deck. Peralta one strike away from taking a 2-1 series lead over the Rays in this huge four-game set from the Bronx. Final game tomorrow afternoon, first pitch around 1:35 here at Yankee Stadium on Mother's Day. Top of the ninth inning, 3-2 pitch coming after the mound visit from Trevino. The 3-2. On the way, it's upstairs and it's ball four. Arozarena works a walk. And that is going to bring up Lau with the tying run at first base. And the go-ahead run at the plate. Lau singled in his only at-bat in this game in the seventh. Has 7 home runs this year for the Rays. Nail-biting time once again for the Yankees. First pitch. Dribbled foul, 0-1. It always seems like it's nail-biting time here in the Bronx. 0-1 pitch. Awaiting Brandon Lau. Peralta checking at first base on Arozarena. One of his 2 checks over there. 0-1 count on Brandon Lau. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2 on Lau. And Peralta once again one strike away from getting out of it and sending Yankee fans home on a Saturday with a smile. 0-2 from Lau. In the dirt, 1-2. Lau making Peralta work here in the ninth as well, just like Arozarena did. Franco grounded out. Bethancourt struck out. Arozarena walked. Now the 1-2 coming from Wandy Peralta. Grounded foul again, still 1-2. On Lau. Taylor Walls is on deck. Another 1-2 coming from Brandon Lau. Another foul ball. Still 1-2. Really, really making Peralta work here in the ninth inning. Peralta one strike away against Brandon Lau. The 1-2. Another foul ball. Still 1-2 on Lau. One, two pitch coming again. 1-2. Another one foul. making Peralta work here in the ninth. It's like on repeat from Brandon Lau against Peralta. Arozarena at first. Two outs. Another 1-2 pitch coming. 1-2. Slider fouled away again. Still 1-2. On Lau. Remember, Taylor Walls is on deck. One, two. Is fouled away again. Still 1-2. What a battle. What a battle between Peralta and Lau. Down to his final strike. Can Peralta get him here? One ball, two strikes, two outs, and time called by Trevino. That would have been a strike. And we're going to do it again. Peralta versus Lau, face-to-face in the ninth, down to their final strike. The 1-2. Popped up. Left field. Cabrera there. Makes the play, and the Yankees once again are the comeback kids and do it again. They come back to beat the Rays down 6-0. They come all the way back and win it in a final score of 9-8 over the Tampa Bay Rays. Anthony Volpe with a stolen base. Cabrera with an RBI single. And that man, Aaron Judge, two home runs. The guy behind him, Kyle Higashioka with a big home run. The final score from Yankee Stadium today, Yankees 9 and the Rays 8. Aaron Judge, two home runs. And the final ends in smiles for the Yankees. Well, it's time for the Cadillac player of the game. Who else but number 99, the Yankee captain. Not one, but two monster home runs for the Yankee captain. Aaron Judge with a home run in the fifth inning, a two-run shot, and another two-run shot in the sixth. Let's take a look at the game summary. 8-12-0 for the Rays, 9-10-0 for the Yankees. Cordero got the win. Peralta got the save. First comeback win from down six since 2019 on June 23rd at the Minnesota Twins. Well, we're going to say saying so long here from Yankee Stadium on a gorgeous Saturday afternoon. Nestor Cortes Jr. got the start and does not pick up a decision, but the Yankees pick up a win. Some great pitching for the first few innings. Some great defense. Some big, long home runs. Diaz, Higashioka, and of course, the captain. Not once, but twice. So long from Yankee Stadium. Final score one more time. Yankees 9 and the Tampa Bay Rays 8 on this beautiful Saturday afternoon. Sending it to the WB Mason postgame show.